Hey guys, what's going on? James here. Yes, I got another update for the 75-gallon saltwater reef tank. But first off, I'm going to do some shout-outs. All right, I got a few shout-outs. I've got DJME1BD, which would be DJME1BD. Shalom Toribio. Ugly Diego 66, Curtis Maximus 123, Max Luxidas, the Game Boy 56, Giovanni Urso, John He 12345, Abel. I got a new user. Thank you very much to the new user, whoever you may be. I got Rafa L. And finally, we got Carlos Jones. Guys, check out these channels. Really do appreciate it, guys, for your subscriptions. Really great. Keep them coming. And I'll keep them shout outs rolling. I also want to give a shout out to Andrew, which is Simianko, on daretoreef.ning.com because he guessed pretty close on something. I said I would give him a shout out for doing it. So there's to you, buddy. I gave you a shout out. All right, guys. Something big happened to this tank today. I've been getting a lot of flack about the clam. It needs to be higher to the light. Yada, 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 yada. So, I got it higher to the light. Oh. Is that high enough to the light? That is the top of that clam. About 10 inches from the bottom of the light. Alright. That is one massive, giant rock. That is cured Fiji rock from the exact same tank that I've been getting all my Fiji rock, or I should say got, which was quite a while ago. So, yeah, that is one massive piece of rock. Let me show you how this thing is looking under here. Pretty awesome, right? I still have my Coralie over here, blowing down in here. And I put the frag rack up here. I might take the frag rack out because I got a pretty big frag rack going on in this piece. This is a 16 by 13 piece of cured live rock. Like I said, Fiji. 21 pounds, that's $6 a pound. You've got $123 for this one single piece of rock. Yep. This clam, he would not come off that rock. So, anyhow, let's hope Clammy decides to stay put. I ended up moving most of my corals out of the way just to give him room in case he decides to take a plunk. He should go straight down and land about right there somewhere. So hopefully he's not gonna. He's been hammering himself onto that rock. He's loving his spot. So that's what it's gonna be. Nothing on this one yet. I was going to start doing some gluing of frags, but it was just a matter of getting this big rock and stuff in here, so I said the heck with it. Like I said, I did move the corals around. There's the one hammer that I had gotten from John off of eBay. Beautiful little hammer. What else did we do here? Oh, I put the candy cane over here. I put everything really close to the rocks just to kind of calm them down. I have it on the low setting as far as the WP-40. So, just kind of letting everything chill out a little bit. Everything is looking great, though. I mean, these corals are just digging this. Look at these things. Looking really awesome. So, yeah, I'm really liking that. All responding. And, hey, where did that little bitty guy go? Oh, that's the one, okay. I thought I had a tiny one. Oh, I moved it. And for the record, that mushroom I said that David had sent me last night, that's actually from Andrew Simianko. So, sorry about that, Andrew. I talked to you and David so much, I'm starting to get you guys all mixed up. But there's my little mushroom garden going on. Still have one tiny little guy inside the bucket. But yeah, that's what's going on over here in this corner. That's the other hammer right there that I had gotten from Petco. He looks a little upset at the moment. So we'll let him be and do his thing. He hasn't been really popping open lately. I think he's mad because of the move. Of course, you got the anemone, you've got the eagle eyes. Corals are looking really awesome. Like I said, they're really digging what's going on in this tank, which is really making me happy and making me really willing to keep just messing with this thing, you know, and get it looking as best as I possibly can. Got a bunch of tiny little frags right down here, and those there, and the pallies are fighting with these guys for that spot, so that's interesting. A little tiny one right there. Yeah, right there. There's a little single guy right there. At least I think it's single. Oh no, actually there's a little polyp right there. A couple of little polyps. So. And the devil's armor, which is right there. Really pretty. I like these corals. The only ones that I haven't had any really spark out of are, let's see if I can find them. This is pretty tough. Yeah, right down is right there. I don't know if I can get them or not. Those pallies that Andrew had sent. Not that he did anything wrong, it's just, I think he said they were electric blues or something. Yeah, I can't even get a focus on them. They're back there in the back part of that rock, but it's those three right there. They just don't want to do nothing. So it is what it is. Then you got my aching garden over here. The glass on the bottom is dirty. I still didn't get to that part of it. There's the one. And here's the other one. And for the record, guys, where is he at? See that Aiken? Remember the green and red one? See how come he looks like, what the heck happened to him? Well, it's because that guy right there, he was on a rock when it was down lower. He jumped off and he decided to use that little Aiken as his landing pad. So I don't know if it's going to make it or not. Kind of upset about that. But, I don't know. What are you going to do? Clam versus Aiken. It looks like the clam won that battle. There's the pulsing zinnia hiding. It's under the shadow of the rock, so I'll have to see how that works out. And then the colostrophe, I believe is how you call it. Or David said it the other night, but I don't even care anymore, guys. It's just an awesome looking coral, so enjoy it. Call it whatever you want. It's just a wild looking little coral. And then up here on top, you've got my pink bird's nest right here in the front. I really don't know if any polyps are out or not. Probably too close to even be able to tell. And with my eyes right at the moment, I really doubt that I'm able to get anything anyway. But, yeah, that one's a little rough right there. He's going to replace like 5 or 6 of these, which is really nice of him. So, that's really awesome. Great guy he is. So if you guys ever need frags or whatever, make sure to check this guy out on eBay. I posted his description on eBay after I was asked by, I believe it was Mike Jones or Jack, one of the two. But some of them, I mean, have the polyp extensions and whatnot, so it's just a matter of who's going to survive or not, you know. He's had a rough go. The spongeoid is looking really cool. I like the spongeoid. His polyps were all over the place today. I don't know how well they look right now, but like I said, I can't really get in. With my eyes, they're just not focusing tonight. Yeah, they're out from what I can tell. So that's pretty cool. That's all the way down to the base too, those extensions. That poor frag right there didn't make it. That was the green tip Monty. Really sad. This one here, I'm not really positive. I think it was another type of Monty, I believe. And then my Slimer, I don't think there's anything coming out of my Slimer. That bird's nest seems to be doing okay. It's a dark colored bird's nest. I guess that's the metallic green one. I have to go to the side over here. Hopefully the camera will do something here. That one right there is a goner. That's the one that caused all the snotty, slimy stuff. So, ends up being about 5 or 6 frags that couldn't cut it. It's a bummer, but, you know, what are you going to do? So, we'll see. But, yeah, I hope you guys like my latest deal with this massive piece of rock. I'll give you a full shot of what this tank looks like now. It almost looks like a sombrero. That is one crazy piece of rock. I can't wait for the coralline to kick in on that. That's going to just look totally awesome. All right, guys, with that, thanks for watching. Really do appreciate it. And thanks again to all the new subs. Have a great evening, guys. Bye-bye.